Hi everybody, so today I'm going to be doing kind of a review slash haul video for you. It is going to be all based on mascara. It is part one of four parts for you. Also to kind of start off, sorry I'm in my kitchen. I told you guys before I'm kind of settling in still, so I'm trying to figure out where I can do things and I don't have a desk and I'm just trying to kind of wing it. But other than that, so I am going to do a four videos for you, kind of on mascaras, because I realized in my past videos, I do tell you guys I'm a huge MAC person, but the one product I never use from MAC is mascara. My sister has like three or four different kinds, well she has had like three or four different kinds, and every time I borrow it, or just kind of, sorry, my phone is going off there, every time I borrow something, I hate it. Like, it doesn't work right with my lashes, it only clumps, and the brush is too small or too big, and I don't know, I have so many problems with MAC mascara. So my go-to is actually Maybelline, and I was like, why not do a review for drugstore mascaras, because everyone can pick these up. You can get them at Target, you can get them at Long, Safeway, Albertsons, some specialty stores obviously will have them, but just kind of wherever you go to, you can just pick it up. They're a lot cheaper, and I was like, why not? So, in each part of the video, I'm going to do kind of my little review on each one. I'm going to start with my Maybelline, Great Lash Blackest Black, because that's what I normally go to. That's my normal, use, and then I also picked up one recently that is a Rimmel. I'm going to go with Rimmel because I know some people pronounce it differently, but don't get mad or anything if you actually know the right way to say it and I'm saying it wrong, but that's what I'm going to call it. And anyway, so I picked up one from them that I've actually been using recently because I got kind of tired of this mascara and I was like, you know, this is a great opportunity too for me to try out some new ones and see if I like something better. So I did get one of theirs that I have been kind of using. And then I picked up two that I've never tried before. So that's why it's slightly haul-ish, because I was like, I don't really use it. And then also my sister was like, you know, I want to start buying cheaper mascara because, like, why not if I like it? And I was like, sure, I'll buy some and let you know what I think. Because we kind of have really similar lashes. Hers are a little bit shorter than mine, but for the most part, we have pretty long lashes. And that's the other part of this video I do want to say is, I have long lashes as it is, so we might be looking for different mascara types only because of that. I look for really black mascara. I love dark, anything that's going to make my eyes pop more. And then I also like either a smaller brush that you can use that will still put on a lot of mascara, but you don't have to keep like messing in between your eyelashes, because I don't want to sit there for like 5 minutes being like, this is ridiculous, when I can use a different like brush and be done in 2 seconds. So I mean, some people buy brushes and they kind of like put it in their mascara and then just don't even use it when it comes with it, but I'm like, that's just too much effort and it's gonna make a mess, so nah. Anyway, so to kind of get started, I'm gonna explain what I've been using. So I use the Great Lash Maybelline New York Blackest Black. And this is a 0.43 fluid ounces. I normally go through one of these in probably 2 or 3 months. I don't really replace them very often. I know some people say you are supposed to replace it every month. Some people say you're supposed to replace it every 2 months. And I'm like, I replace it when I feel like I'm not getting any mascara on my eyelashes, or it takes too much effort and I keep like re-dipping. And I know that it's really bad for your mascara anyway, because when you keep like taking it out and going like this, you're adding air pressure in there and it's just drying out your mascara. So if I have to keep doing that, I'm like, okay, it's time for a new one. Or if I feel like when I'm putting it on, it's like crisping my lashes, then I'll get a new one also. But like I said, it normally takes me 2-3 months for one of these, maybe a little bit longer, maybe a little bit less. It also kind of depends. Sometimes I like to add water to my brush, which is very rare, and I did that for a long time. And then I kind of stopped because I just realized it's messing up my brushes, it's making my mascara dry out faster, and it hurts. I know, it's weird, but it does. So, anyway, so it lasts me a great amount of time, I think. If you guys use mascara however long you do, let me know, and I might just be crazy. But anyway, so that's what I've been using. On this brush, it's actually very small. I don't know if you guys can see it very well. But yeah, it's a pretty small brush. It's like fingernail wise, it's small. So the pros and cons I like about this mascara, I love that it's really, really dark black. I do tend to sometimes interchange it with a larger brush in just black, which has a green lid, but I really like the black. I go for black. I can't help it. So, I don't know. It kind of depends what kind of brush size you like too. But the small brush, what I like with this one is it seems to always go through my lashes really nicely, and I never really have clumps. So each, just to let you guys know too, in each series I will actually be wearing that mascara that day. So today I am wearing this mascara, and then in the following parts I'll be wearing those mascaras that I review, so you guys can kind of see the difference also. But I like that it doesn't leave like huge clumps. It does make my eyelashes black. The only thing I don't really like about it is it doesn't really extend. Like it doesn't have a, it doesn't grab on to where it leaves like a thickness to it, to where it makes your lashes look like thicker and longer. And even though my lashes are already really long, I don't need it. So that's why I think I've always tended to go towards this. But it'd be nice. It's still nice to have longer, it's still nice to have thicker, and it's nice to have them noticeable. But I do like that it doesn't clump. And when it does, it's normally because I'm either need to switch my bottle because it's just done, or I'm kind of like overlapping throughout the day, which I don't really do ever unless I'm going out at night somewhere and I'm like, what happened to my lashes right there? I don't know. So I'll kind of fix that. But I really don't do that. I normally put one on each day, and that's about it. Oh, the other thing too that I tend to never go for in mascaras is I hate waterproof mascara. Most women and girls and ladies and whatever you like to be called love waterproof mascara, and I think it's absolutely ridiculous, because when I'm wearing mascara in general, yeah, like if I go swimming or something, yeah, it's gonna go run a little bit, or if I like rub my eye, it's gonna rub off. But for the most part, like waterproof mascaras don't come off me. Like I will be sitting there with mascara, like rubbing my eyes, washing my face, like using makeup remover, and I can never get it all off. Like even if I get most of it off, there's still some there, and then I'll shower the next, because I shower every morning, so I'll shower the next morning and it'll just be ridiculous. I cannot get it off at all, and it just, I feel like it almost ruins my eyelashes. I don't know, I just hate it. So, needless to say, waterproof mascara is not in any of these. I hate waterproof, and if there is one that is waterproof, it was a complete accident, which I should probably double check that, but I don't think any of them are. They shouldn't be, and yeah, that is my one review about waterproof mascaras. They suck. So if you guys like them, awesome. I'm glad they work for you, but they suck for me. So anyway, if you guys want to know any other questions about this mascara, let me know. I do really like it overall. From a 1 to 10, I give it a 9.5, probably maybe 9. Like I said, I am getting a little bit tired of it. That's why one of the reasons I wanted to do these videos and kind of try out new mascaras to begin with. But overall, I really like it. I've used it for years, like I said. And then I also switch out between my brushes, or the green and the black, just because it adds a little bit of a thicker brush when I do kind of get tired of the small, or if I get tired of the thick, I'll switch back to the small. But in general, I love the blackest black the best. If they had a little bit bigger brush, I would probably be a little bit happier, but I like this one for non-clumping. I think it's nice, and it kind of separates. So, I don't know how well this is going to show, but I'm going to kind of just try to show my eyes so you guys can have a better look at what the mascara looks like. So sorry if this is kind of weird, or if you can't hear me very well, or it just looks really awkward. But I'm just kind of trying to show you what the mascara looks like and how it works on me. Like I said, I already have pretty long eyelashes. For the most part, it doesn't really clump. I think today I have a little bit of clumping, but that was my fault, right here on this side here. But anyway, for the most part, it works pretty well. I like it, and hopefully I'll insert some pictures that I'll have a better view for you. But in general, that's all I got, and I hope you like part one of the mascara review. If you, like I said, if you have any more questions about this mascara, I'll be happy to inform you the best I can. And I hope you like this video, so thumbs up, and I'll see you on part two.